be, as always, is Argeros.
What's up? So is this a bad time to be eating chips?
Yes. I will reach through the internets and strangle you with my penis.
How much of a douchebag move would that be? You want to do some cool commentary? I'm eating chips.
Om nom nom. What do you want? What? And this is the previous battle. I would like to stipulate. I had this thing decked out for league play, because I am the safety switch on Himmelsdorf, and I had no fire extinguisher because in league play you don't really expect to live that long in tier six. So yeah, I kind of burned and exploded, and then swapped the rations back to a fire extinguisher. We had Shoot with me here in the KV-2, and Aerator, as you can see, charging forward boldly in the M6, mainly because that thing has amazing engine power, and also doesn't weigh as much as Jupiter.
True story.
For reals. And you might want to also have an eye on the team chat a little later on, because I get kind of accused of shit.
If people aren't accusing you of hacking, you're not doing something right, as far as I'm concerned.
That is correct. I did get accused at least once, if not twice, in Strongholds when I was bringing the KV-2. They said I had an aimbot. Like, check the stats. I'm kind of good in the KV-2. I got a tank sniper medal on the KV-2. No idea how that works, but I'll take it. Here's me trying to... I'm just trying to egg Aerator on. Just kind of, come on! Actually, we were really waiting for Shoot, but what are you going to do? And at this point, I get really impatient.
Don't worry, you're in the strong Russian steel.
Indeed. I just cut him off, pin him against the mountain, because I'm a dick.
The hand of Stalin.
Jawohl. Wait, that's not the right language. Oh, KV-85. Ho. Sit back in there. Yes. Oh. So this match I'm going to preface right before I blow the shit out of this guy. Yeah, that happens.
Aimbot.
Hashtag aimbot. Yes. So I'm going to preface the whole battle by saying that this doesn't end up in a shit ton of medals or anything. It's just kind of one of those fights that you remember. And I thought I'd share it with my good friend, Arge.
Aw, yeah.
We spent all this time coming all the way around this fucking mountain. They pushed their big-ass heavy tanks right up Death Valley. And our heavy tanks and everybody else involved is just dying because they're bad.
What I like is the Firefly and the Cheeto. Yeah. Not doing anything on the corner.
No, yeah. They're like, we'll hang back here, guys. Like, well, can you try and shoot things that are attacking us? No. Taters going in.
Bros. Yeah. Nothing's coming around this mountain.
Nope. Taters has gone in. He's got behind the AT. And
the shoot. Oh, shoot, just fucking wrecked that BK.
Yeah, he did. owned. That 100
gonna get wrecked by the SU-100Y though.
It's very possible, very very possible, yes.
Yeah, that's what happened.
Called it. And so I don't know where the 67 went, but I'm guessing he went down the hill when he saw the KV-2s. The T-1 Heavy is there in the south trying to bottle up the 100Y, I guess. And I'm really not interested in an M4 shooting me in the ass with a derp cannon, so I thought I'd return the favor.
Fair enough.
Yep. And now I can rain down shells from above, except they have a couple of artillery. So I gotta be mindful of that. And our T1 Heavy just bit it against the 100Y, and Taters is wrecking shop, but he's only got 132 hit points. If he was driving the strong Russian steel, he'd probably have more hit points.
Indeed. Do you wreck the Arl coming up?
No, I don't know. Oh, fuck. Listen here, buddy. It's not worth my time to try and fully aim or completely turn around, so...
Don't worry, Stalin guides your shots.
Yes, as well as protects my face. I got a little extra help there. Aerator is down. Repeat, Aerator is down. And I think it's about this time that I start getting accused of shit. I could be wrong, I really wasn't paying attention, but I am paying attention to that 100 Y.
What's a Frommers?
I don't know. Maybe he was trying to say fun, or...
Combine, like, four words?
I don't know. But there's a certain amount of shit-talking that I was completely ignoring, because I was waiting for that 100 Y to pop out.
I love this KV-1, the enemy KV-1, like, we're up tanks, better cap.
Yep, exactly. And he's the only one on there. So, time for the fur fly and the Cheetos to rain down the hills. And where the fuck is this KV-1, this 100Y? He doesn't have that good camo. So, if he ain't gonna do that, then I'm gonna pull back around and probably try and help out my boys crushing things on cap.
Yeah, yeah.
Dun, 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 and the SUA. Like, where
does people come from?
Oh, look, it's 100Y. Fuck. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
Shazam.
Yarp.
How you have not been hit by artillery yet is beyond me.
Oh, wait. Dead's cussed. They're gonna try. But if anybody's played some World of Warships, they know that hitting shit at distance with big guns ain't really all that accessible. And I'm already getting a GG. It's 2-on-3, and I'm already getting the GG from the artillery. I'm selling this already. Well, you should have had it before the nerf. Before the nerf, it was good. No, not quite. Not quite.
It would have been awesome if you would have splash killed that guy.
Yes. I have splash killed people many a time. I've gone many a time in the KV-2 as I charge towards a large outcropping of rock, if I can make it. Many times in the KV-2 I've gone 100% shooting and got some additional splash hits here and there for fun. It's more fun than a bag already.
Have you ever got bombardier?
No, very, very close. Very, very close a few times. A couple of, you know, one low-tier TD open top next to a low-health medium tank kind of a deal, but I never get that much splash radius. They're just never close enough. But I usually nuke one or the other anyway. So at this point, I thought about going all the way down the 5 line and camping there at like KJ5 and looking through the window. But I'm too lazy to go that far. And this is a big enough rock anyway. So I don't really want to expose myself too much, but I do want to be aimed up.
I like this Firefly.
Yes.
I'm going to let the KV-2 be the sniping support tank, and I'm going to charge up there.
And I was wondering, is he going to really have the balls to move in? Because if he does, then I'm going to be happy. But if he doesn't, then we're kind of going to be real sad and get picked off individually. Because I ain't got the reload time to keep up with this. And I'm not really sure what possessed my brain to keep herky-jerky and back and forth.
Reasons.
Indecision.
KV-2 Simon Sport Tank called it.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Not far enough. Very close. Yes, thank you.
I am disappointed.
As well am I. You have no idea. So now I gotta hide, and I gotta hope that the Firefly doesn't get nuked. Well, nuked a little bit, but not too much.
Oh, the Amex 105 senses the blood in the water.
Try and lead the target. No, I did not lead the target. That was a bad shot. 67's right there. SU-8 is behind the thing. Firefly gets the AMX. 67 on the move. Not really a viable target for a sniping support KV-2. And no, I've not healed my radio man because fuck that guy. I was kind of hoping that I wouldn't have to use any repair kits. But if I did, multiple guys would be better than, you know.
Oh, you hit the blind shot? Oh, nice.
And I got a thanks. That's awesome. I saw the tree go down. I just said, well, maybe if I elevate my shot. I didn't get the top gun. The Firefly got the top gun, but he went face first into danger, so I have no real problems with that. So, all of that nonsense capped off with the blind shot over the rock onto the Yardie. I got no words for that one, but it was entertaining.
Spread the needle.
Indeed, very much so. Thank you very much, sir, for your co-commentary utilizations.
Not a problem.
And we will see you on the flip side, or, you know, something.